continuar con estas jornadas.
We're going to resume the session. Now we have the second speaker. As I said previously, he's going to talk about the developments of the game in France with 100 short causes. As you know, Madrid has made an important commitment with Pitch and Pad. We are having really good results, and we expect that the members of the Pitch and Pad committee that made this question previously can have a full answer now. José Antonio, I think that you'll be interested about this issue as well, so please pay attention to see what they tell us and how we can get or achieve a radar.
I am Pierre Lasfargue. I'm from the French Golf Federation. First of all, I would like to apologize. I never met Severiano Ballesteros. I am here today to talk about growing the game of golf in France until 2018, as the date of the Ryder Cup in France. I will show you a slideshow. After, I would like to show you again a movie for 5 minutes. And between, I'd like to say a few words about traditional courses, because as you will see, we have put the course until our strategy of development, and we are going to present a program to our clubs next year about the great course. Our strategy. First, we made a master plan. Each federation of sport in France realized a master plan in order to know what we are going to do for the next years. And we make a master plan about development of golf by facilities. And the 100 compact urban golf course is inside this plan, because in 2008, when we bid for the Ryder Cup, we thought that it was a good idea to put this plan of development into our offer. We consider that for us, the Ryder Cup is like a comet. We don't know when we will see it again. And we would like to leave for the legacy. We would like that this plan, this 100 compact golf course, will be the legacy left by the Ryder Cup in France. So how we manage this plan since 7 years? We have 4 elements. First, we need to identify the population of golfers, who they are, why they play, where they play, many things like that. After, we have to target pertinent suitables. It's important to know where we could find suitable locations. After, we need to support project holders. We need to accompany, to help people who come to the federation and say, we would like to build a golf course. How could we do that? And after, we try to guarantee some money with state subsidies in France. First, to identify current members and facilities. As you can see in the graph, since in 2008, before we start the program, we have a regular progression of our players in France, and we begin to have a decreasing in the last 3 and 2 years. Regarding the courses, you can see there is a big progression for the construction of courses in France, and from 1988 to 1995, near of 400 courses were built in France. But in 2008, there was a very important decreasing for the construction of course. So it was the fact that we decided that the plan will be around the construction of courses. But you have 2 questions at this moment. To know what type of courses we have to build, and for what type of golfer, of players. Regarding supply and demand, you can see the in France the type of player, the kind of player, is maybe specific, but not very far than in Spain or England. We are about a man of which is who is 50 years old around, and majority of men, and we have only 10% of juniors. Regarding the supply, in France, at the beginning of the plan, we have globally monotype, big hole, course around 50 hectares, and this kind of supply brings many, many troubles for us. Many troubles because with this kind of golf course, we need to play 4 or 5 hours. These kind of courses are not very close to catchment area. And we have a problem of cost for new players. And the problem is this type of course is very challenging for beginners and older players. So we thought that if we change the course, we change the players, and we change the image of golf in France. What was the deal? So what we need, we are in the core of the project, we need compact urban courses close to catchment areas. Because, you know, we have many breaks, we have many problems in France with the cost, with the time, with the difficulty to play golf, and all the answers are in this type of course. So, but the most important thing for us in France, it's to find the choice of the location of the course. We need to find course place which are very close to the town, because we have a problem with young people, and if you haven't a car, you can't reach currently the course in France. And it's the reason why we have only 40,000 players, young players in France, and it's not enough. After we, you can see the different elements: affordable, open to all, easy and quick to play. The easy to play and quick to play. It's very important. It's very important point. You can see currently many discussion about the time in golf. It's a real problem, and we have a solution for the traditional golf. I will say a few words about that after. And sustainable development in France, it's something which is very important, and we signed a charter, an agreement with three ministries, agriculture, environment, and sport, to guarantee that the new courses will be will not use many water and many product phytosanitary. After the target, that's a point very interesting for us. We need to find place to build the new courses. So for this question, we made a lot of survey, and as you can see on the map on the left, you can see a spot in blue. The lot of spots in blue, there are more or less 200, represent catchment area in France. And if you see the little flag in black, you can see they represent golf course in France. And only 50% of the flag are in a catchment area. So we have a problem to link people to the course. And it's a point very important for us. So we decided to make a national analysis in France, and in order to know where it's possible for the future to build a big 18 holes course or compact course for all over in France. And at the end, we decided that it was more relevant to choose to make our plan around compact courses more than traditional courses. How the Federation is involved in this plan? First, we decide to create a team inside the Federation. We have two people, Julien and Thomas, which are in the room here. Okay. And they are in contact with all the project holders every day during all the year. After, we decided to create an advisory document for the project holders, and we made surveys. You can see the figure regarding the number of documentation we sent to people, the survey we realized, and diagnostic, technical diagnostic. And after, we decided to have an agreement with a government body in order to obtain subsidies, state subsidies, for the project holder. It was not easy in France to do that. You can imagine. Regarding the state subsidies, the agreement we had with the public authority, which is National Center for Sport Development, guarantee more or less 50% of the cost of the program is paid by the state. But we have eligibility criteria. We are talking about public courses, and the course must be close to a catchment area. After, sustainable development, for sure, and it's an agreement between Federation and the National Center for Sport Development. When there is a new project, the state said to us, if this project is in our master plan. If you say yes, we can go on to obtain subsidies. It's a point very interesting, because we would like to at the beginning to obtain a location close to the town, and in this fact the owner is the city, and it's a program for the city at the beginning. Where are we to date? 7 years after, where are we to date? If you see this map, you can find many figures, and I can give you some explanation. When we make our national survey, we find that it was possible to create 220 golf courses. Big or compact, there was not a restriction. As we said, we decided, no, compact course, sorry. Our plan, the scale of our plan was 10 years. So we decided to be reasonable, that it was more feasible to have an objective of 100 facilities to build. It's the reason why you can see in different region, a number in red. It's the objective of each region for building a compact course. And the amount of all the figures give 100. That's the reason why we could have a plan with 200, but we decided it was not reasonable, because it's 100 is very difficult to. And as I said, it was not a very quiet way, and we had and we have always difficulties. We have 2,500 contacts since 2008. We had 550 projects, and now we have 120 facilities built. When 120, including big courses, and about traditional courses, we are almost talking about extension. There are not many new courses in France, only 3-4 by year only, that we are more extensions. And we have difficulties. The difficulties in France, it's the image of golf. For many people, the golf in France is for old-fashioned people, rich people, and when we are going to go to the city to say to the mayor, we would like to work with you in order to have a new golf course, it's not obvious, because in France, the city, the mayor, prefer to build a football pitch, because for the sport, the idol in France is football. And when you say no, not a football pitch, a compact course, it's a hard, very hard discussion with them to convince them to accept that we are talking about golf and we are talking about compact course, and it's an equipment for everybody. Private investments running slow. We have the crisis since 3-4 years, and project holders have less money, and it's more difficult since 4 years. The problem of the land available is the real problem, because we are looking for place which are close to city, and it's not really obvious to obtain this 7 or 10 hectares in order to build a course. It's not easy to obtain that. And the last point, but not the least, is the problem with the laws and regulation. In France, it's extremely complex to create a golf course, because there are many, many constraints, and it's a real problem. It's a problem about the time we need to go since the beginning to the end of the project. We need 3 or 4 years. So the actual figure, the project was 100, is 68 compact courses which were built or in progress. And you can see on the right of the screen that we projected in 2008 42 projects in 2015. Why there is a difference? There is a difference because when we start the project, we were talking about autonomous courses. We was new courses, but current golf course, current clubs say which have only a driving range and 18 holes say we need a compact course in our facilities. We need to add this kind of program inside. It's the reason why there is a difference of 26, because the 26 which are the difference are clubs we decided since 2008 to add a compact course inside their equipment. Because they consider, and we consider too, that it's something very useful for in order to develop golf. And we say, okay, we are in the plan. You can see in this map, that this is the map of the 68 compact urban golf which are built at date. You can see that we can find them all over France, and you can see two colors of flag. Maybe you are too far. There are blue flag and green flags. Green are flags regarding compacts which were built in a golf course. To notice, you can see that there is only 15% of courses which are public courses. We would like at the beginning to have more and more, but for the reason I explained before, for the constraint, it's more difficult to build a public course. If you are a mayor, it takes more time, many time, a lot of time. And the point which is very interesting is synthetic greens, synthetic grass for greens and tees. It represents 30% of the program. And it's something very interesting, and it's an opportunity for some project. So, in fact, we at the end we consider an average that each structure bring 400 members. You can see that we have currently 400,000 members in France with license, and we have around 70 compact courses, and we are around 25 or 30,000 new members with this plan. And you, I will show you some picture of courses, and I will comment each one. But it's a real program of development. We have around between 25 or 30,000 new players. Some pictures. Here we are near Tours. It's a pitch and putt, 18 holes, and it was one of the first one we had in our plan. We have for this program 400 members and 30,000 green fees. 13,000 green fees. Sorry. Here we have near of the Golf National in France, where we could see the French Open this week and the Ryder Cup in 2018. There is no problem of concurrency because there are 800 members in this program. Here we are in near of Paris. You can see how the program is integrated in the city. The program were built in a floatable zone, and it was built in a part of Paris who is not very rich. We are in the east of Paris, northeast of Paris. Northeast of Paris. It was a good opportunity for us with this program in closer to Paris. Here we are near Reims, the city of Reims in Champagne. It's a synthetic grass for green and tees. The program here is a program which is built in a course, in a club, in a golf club, with synthetic grass too. This is a program in Longwy, in the north of France. After we are compact nine holes. Here we are. You can see the program, which is near Clermont-Ferrand in the center of France. You can see the town, which is all around the golf compact, the compact course of 18 holes. In Clermont-Ferrand, again, we have another compact course of 18 holes. And this is the last pictures. The picture, sorry, synthetic grass for green, and we have electric lawnmower for this course. I would like to show some example. You can see that there is a variety of compact course. There are pitch and putt, golf compact, synthetic, very close to the city, and nice to play, I think. Just before the movie, which is just after. I would like to say a few words about traditional course. As you can see, this kind of program is the answer about the problem of the golf, which is long time, which is the difficulty to play, which is the price, and our traditional course in France. 18 holes said we have a problem with our player. It's too difficult for new players to play it from traditional tees, tournament tees to play, and we need something new. We discovered 2 years ago a program from the SPGA in the USA. It was Teed Forward, and we decided to create two new tees in France and to propose that to our clubs. The first two new tees, which are forward, the red one in France. The red one is the tees for the women. That is a problem when I say that. And we decide to create two new tees. The first tees will be correspond to a course of 2,700 meters. The other tees correspond to a course of 4,300 meters. And after we have the traditional tees, you can see in every clubs. These tees are made for young players, beginners, and old players who can have a length of drive very good, and they decide to play a shorter course. And we are going to propose to our clubs to install two new tees after a test we made with 17 clubs with a system like Teed Forward, like the American system, Teed Forward. And we are going to, we think that for the future, players must play in leisure from the tee which correspond to the length of his drive. Not you don't play here because it's decided before. You play here because it's better for you. You can decide where you play, but currently next year you will find six tees on each clubs. We decide to install them. I would like to say that because it was not easy to explain that inside the federation. But we saw that the problem of the time, the problem of the difficulty, we lost a lot of players, and we have players which are in average 50 years old. It's a problem when they play always from back tees. I would like to say that during this discussion because it's linked to the problem. So. I have a last, where I was talking about the comet of the Ryder Cup, like a comet. I hope we will see you in Ogolf National in 2018. And I would like to show you a movie we have just finished last week. I haven't the subtitles in English. I'm sorry, it's in French, but I think you could appreciate it.
La Ryder Cup doit nous aider à donner un coup de projecteur sur la pratique du jeu, changer l'image élitiste que le golf peut encore avoir en France.
Ces petites structures répondent à deux freins identifiés à la pratique du golf. Le premier frein étant la distance, le second après au prix de pratique de la discipline.
On est vraiment sur un concept de golf urbain, proche des villes, accessible, une des 100 petites structures voulues par la Fédé. C'est assez simple, vous pouvez louer un club, ça vous coûte 2 euros. Vous prenez un saut de balle, ça coûte 2 euros. Donc pour 4 euros, vous pouvez jouer pendant une petite demi-heure. Donc on est vraiment dans cette idée de politique tarifaire agressive pour mettre un maximum de gens au golf et changer un petit peu les a priori que l'on pouvait avoir.
Comme le fait un saut de balle le soir, sentir une incidence importante sur la vie de famille, sur la vie au travail. Le fait de dire je viens, je prends ma voiture, je ne pose pas trop de questions sur mon habit, façon de me tenir. Quand on casse un petit peu cette barrière-là, déjà on s'aperçoit que, comme on le voit, quelqu'un comme Sophie, des fois c'est un matin, j'ai avec ses copines le matin, et puis elle peut retourner tranquillement, si elle récupère ses enfants midi à l'école, elle est capable de le faire, elle est en mesure de le faire.
La particularité du golf, c'est que quand on fait un concours de putting ou même un petit parcours, même un débutant peut rivaliser avec un bon joueur. Hein. On peut très bien rentrer un pote de 4 mètres, 5 mètres et un joueur confirmé ne pas y arriver. Hein. Donc effectivement, le golf, c'est ça aussi. Hein. Primaires qui viennent sur les installations, on a 120 jeunes en école de golf, parce qu'il y a une primaire pour les samedis. On a également un public de sport adapté, également dans l'e-golf, beaucoup de public adulte qui fréquente les installations, et puis également nos seniors qui viennent également sur l'air. C'est le seul sport véritablement transgénérationnel. Mon père a plus de 80 ans, il joue avec mon fils qui a 8 ans, et je pense qu'il y a très peu de sports qu'une personne de 84 ans peut pratiquer avec un enfant de 8 ans.
Fédération française de golf, c'est bien, c'est de faire prendre conscience aux collectivités que créer un parcours de golf avec un exploitant qui a une exploitation du golf derrière, ben, ça a du sens aussi, c'est l'aménagement du territoire qui est aussi sympa, et il y a finalement assez peu de risques.
I thank you for your attention, and I'm ready to answer to any questions if you have.
Yes, Pierre, have you got always the same structure in all the facilities, or each one goes its way? Namely, you've got a state-owned piece of land, local government, federal government, then private investors run by privates. How does it work? And does it always work the same way?
No. We have, in fact, we have two kind of people who come with to us in order to know how to build a golf course. You are talking about compact courses. Huh? And we have the majority of the project holder are private. There are men who have a space, a location, and they said, I would like to build a golf course here. But they don't know how it's possible, the problem of the law, the problem of the capability to the golf to reach the good economic model. So we receive all the people. We have many call phone every day, and we organize meeting with them, and we propose to each project holder a survey in order to know if it's relevant to create a golf course in this place regarding the people around. It's the name of the survey. It's a survey about the potential of this compact, about population.
Okay, but what I mean, it's the starting point is always the same. Is it the piece of land near the urban areas? Are they private owned or state owned, or can be both?
We can have two type of.
If is it the state owned, how do they deal with the private investors? Do you bring them?
Yes.
Do you bring them?
Yeah. There is something which was changed since 2008. At the beginning, we had a state community mayor who said, I would like to build a golf course. And I pay for that.
And after that.
I give it to someone to manage it. They don't, in France, they don't like to manage the course directly. They prefer to give it to someone with a contract, with an agreement, and the people who take the agreement pay to the city a fee each year and manage the course. Now it's more difficult, because the town in France have less money, and they say, okay, I give you the place to build the golf, but I don't build the golf. You pay for building they propose to private people to pay for build the course, but they only give the place. and they say, go on, I give you the place, build the course, and manage the course if you want. But now it's very difficult to find a city with a mayor who say, okay, I pay everything.
And how you communicate that? How you lure the private investors, the holders? How do you lure them to come to the game, invest and run?
We have a different way to communicate. We have our website where there is a part and many people saw where it's in our website. They discover the contact of the Federation. They call Julien or Thomas and ask, hello, I would like to build a course, blah, 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 and it's the beginning of the story. And we have, it's for everybody with the website, which is the best website for golf in France. There is no problem about that. And after, we have an exhibition each year in Paris. It's an exhibition which concerns all the mayors in France about different topic. And we have a place for us, for the Federation, and we can meet every mayor. We come in our place and say, I saw that the Federation have a plan about compact courses. Can you explain me how to do? And we can have a lot of meeting during a week in Paris. But in fact, the majority of the contact come from the website of the Federation.
So because the private investors, do they think running small facilities it's a good business? Is that the impression they have in France?
The question is, a compact course is not, if you decide to build a compact course, it's the beginning of the story. After, you have to manage it. And it depends of the man who manages the course. And because it's not like a traditional course. In a traditional course, you have someone for the course, someone for the desk, someone for the administration, etc. For in a compact course, there is one man, and in fact, it's a professional of golf. He knows how to learn to golf to people, and after he knows what is golf, and he has a lot of job with him. He manages the club, he does the administration, he's in charge of the training, everything. So you need to have the good person for the course. And we have a lot of courses which are managed by professionals of golf, and it's the best idea because they know what is golf. But you see, if you have not a good manager, and if the place where the golf is located is not good, far from the town, far from the city, you will have some problems.
Okay, Pierre, and my last question, sorry about that. It's in terms of permissions, law regulations, have you got a master agreement with the federal government, with the departmental governments, or do they go case by case?
It's where we go case by case. But in fact, for compact course, the law and regulation are less restrictive than for a traditional course, because we are talking about 7 or 10 hectares. It's not a large place, and in fact, we have in France we have a difference between declaration and authorization, and for the compact course we are more inside declaration. It's less restrictive. If you decide to build a traditional course with 50 hectares, you will have a lot of problems in France. Not easy.
Hello. David Gomez from the Federation. I would like to thank your presentation, and I would like to know two things. How much is the price of the build of the new compact courses, and how much is the maintenance after you build the golf course?
For the price, it's not more or less, I can say, if you decide to build this course, We are around 900,000 euros for, and it depends, but around this price. I didn't understand the second part of the question.
The cost of maintenance on the run all the project after the first year.
We are talking about 400,000 euros by year, but it depends if we have synthetic greens, it's not the same thing, but it's around 300 or 400. I'm talking about the charge for each year.
Around the same topic, does the local government get any money from giving the land?
No. The government give us not many money. They only give us money, and it's not a 100% guarantee about the subsidies, the state subsidies of the with the agreement with the central. With the CNDS, the public authority, we give 15% of subsidies of the cost of the Gulf, but only. And it's each year it's a war with them to be sure that the guarantee is always there, always okay. I can say that we have not really we have not money from the French government.
And who is the owner of the land?
The city for a part and the private owners for the other part.
Good morning. Excuse me, in this project, the Ryder Cup 2008-80, how many, you say they eat 100 compact. The compact course including pitch and putt and short course only or another ones?
When I say compact, I'm talking about short courses, which are golf compact and pitch and putt compact. Golf compact for us is less than 1,350 meters. For 9 holes, to 2,700 meters for 18 holes, and pitch and putt is for 18 holes is 1,200 meters for 18 holes. The plan is for pitch compact and pitch and putt, because above 2,700 meters, we are talking about golf course in France. And we haven't a plan for golf course.
Okay. And finally, in this moment, how many courses you have finished in this project?
In this project, I said that we have currently we have 200 projects. We have 68 which are realized or in progress, compact and pitch and putt, and we have about. Traditional course, we have 200 projects too. But it's very difficult to create a traditional course in France currently. The majority are extension 9 to 18 or 18 to 17, but new courses are very rare in France. Only 2-3 by year.
Quería preguntarle el proyecto de pitch and putt.
I wanted to ask you about the project of pitch and putt in these courses. How this affects the new licenses?
Slide, you can see that I was talking about 400 members by compact courses. When I say members, it's a license, with license. Because in France we consider that we have 410,000 players with license, and we know that we have 400,000 players without license. where in fact we have 800,000 players in France, and half of the players have a license. It's one of our problems. We would like that each player have a license. Because our budget in France is made by 80% of our budget is the price of the licenses. And I was talking only people who have license on the figures you have seen on the slide about 400 members. It's 400 members with license for us.
Hola, buenos días. Soy Javier Saiz.
My name is Javier Saiz. My question is, although this is a young project, have you worked out in a survey how many people from a traditional course can move on to the pitch and pad? And if in the long term this is going to affect, this is going to improve the people playing in a traditional course?
We have traditional courses. We say you are going to develop a plan which is a kind of concurrence for us. And we say no, because we are going to create players, and after we are going to in your clubs. I think it depends of the place, of the location of the course regarding the town. If the course is very close to the town, you have more players who stay in the course. But in fact, we think that 50% of the players leave the compact course and go for in traditional course, because they need to drive to play like all the clubs of the all the clubs, and they prefer after to go in a great course. But if the course is located to near of close very close to a city, they prefer to play for 1 hour and stay in the course. It depends of the place of the course. And after, it depends of the attractive side of the clubs which are around. If you have a private course close to the compact course, and if it is expensive to play there, it's a problem to reach this club. It depends of the clubs. We have in France, we have 30% of our clubs which are private, traditional private clubs, and we have 60 and 70 clubs which are commercial clubs, and it's easier to reach this kind of clubs if you begin in a compact course. It was a good answer for you. Have you any other questions? You say for us the development, the course is in the core of the development. It's the main problem. It's the main question, and we have many. We can have. I make a joke about Sebastián Ballesteros, but I think in Spain many players would like to become a golfer because there was Sebastián Ballesteros, but in France. We haven't Sebastián Ballesteros, and it's not only the solution, because in France we have Yannick Noah in tennis, and the Federation of the tennis, the French tennis Federation of Tennis, said to us that Yannick Noah was not there was 20 years ago a big boom in the tennis, but it was not due to Yannick Noah. It was due that they decided. The French Tennis Federation decided to build many, I don't know what is the word for tennis court. They decided to put a lot of tennis court in each town in France. And it was the main reason for the increase of players of tennis in France. Yannick Noah was a plus, but it was not the main reason. It was a structural reason for the development. People play on golf, on the course. If the course is easy to play, close to their home, and short to play, not expensive, you will have more players.
We had mentioned that the issue of price is important. In these new courses, is there a policy, a price policy, like green fees or schools, or each facility has its own prices? When
One of the manager of one of the compact we've seen just before said that I don't know what are the a green fee. It's around. It depends, but it's around 10 or 15 euros in this kind of course. Balls for the driving range, it's two euros, and you can play immediately. And after, the price of the to become a member, when it's possible, it's around 300 euros to become a member and play all the year. We are not in. It's not expensive for sure.
¿Alguna pregunta más?
Any further questions? Well, thank you, Pierre.